Welcome students. Today in our session we are going to revise the first lesson in 9th standard, that is Animal Kingdom. For that you have to concentrate on hierarchy classification. So in that you have to learn what are the categories are present and which is the order of the hierarchy classification, which stands at the first category, that is the highest category of the hierarchy classification, that is kingdom. And kingdom is followed by phylum, then class, order, family, genus, and the lowest category of hierarchy classification is species. You have to concentrate on this. Next we will see about the symmetry and its types. There are two symmetry, one is radial symmetry, another one is bilateral symmetry. Symmetry in the sense the arrangement of body parts and how it is arranged. In radial symmetry, example hydra, starfish and jellyfish. So if we cut through any axis or any plane, you will get the two equal halves. In bilateral symmetry, so you will get the two equal parts if we cut only through the central plane. That is the difference. An example for bilateral symmetry is frog, tortoise, human being, so many things. Next we will move and see about the germ layers. There are three germ layers are there: ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. These are the germ layers. These germ layers will develop into a will develop and form a new organs. So based on the germ layers, animals are classified into diploplastic and triploplastic. Children, note this point. This is very important. Diploplastic in the sense it contains only two germs, ectoderm and endoderm. Mesoderm is absent in diploplastic. In triploplastic, three germ layer will be there: ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderms. So example for triploplastic is rabbit, and example for diploplastic is hydra. Diplo means only ectoderm and endoderm is present. Coming to the coelom. Coelom, it is a body cavity. Based on the body cavity, animals are classified into three categories: acoelomate, pseudocoelomate, and coelomate. Acoelomate, absence of coelom. Example, tapeworm. Pseudocoelomate, that is false body cavity. Example, roundworm. And coelomate, true coelom. The first true coelomate animal is earthworm, frog. These are the examples. So remember that it start from tapeworm, roundworm, and then finally earthworm. And then next we'll see about the first phylum, that is Porifera, and the second phylum is Cylindrata. First we'll see about the Porifera. In that the important points are ossea and spicules. Ossea is the pores. You can see by looking at the picture, you can understand the pores which are present on the top. So these pores are called as ossea. Through that the water enters and all the nutrition are enters. And spicules, the skeletal system is entirely different from other animals. This type of skeletal system is called as spicules. And this is the example for Eupetala, and this is the Cycon. And next coming to the Cylindrata. Cylindrata contains mesoglia. Mesoglia is a jelly-like substances. So looking at these pictures, you can understand these are the jelly-like substances which are present in Cylindrata. That is the important character. Understand which organisms contains mesoglia. Only the Cylindrata contains mesoglia. And these organisms have tentacles. That is, these are the tentacles which are present around the mouth of the organisms. So here also you can see the tentacles which bear these stinging cells and called as nematocyst. So those are important points of the Cylindrata. Concentrate on those points. So mesoglia is a very important word, and example for that is hydra and jellyfish. So you have to remember all the picture, students. Sometimes they may ask by giving the pictures what phylum is this, what organism is this, and what is the special features of these organisms. Like that they may ask. So concentrate on the picture and name of the picture and the phylum and then special characteristics of each pictures. Next we'll see about the third and fourth phylum, that is Platyhelminthes, which is otherwise called as flatworm. This name also very important because these organisms have flat like structures, so these are called as flatworms. Platy flat. And Ascelminthes, which is round in the tip. So it is known as roundworm. So you can see the round structures at the corners. So these are called as roundworms. And coming to the platyhelminthes, the special characteristics of these organisms are bilateral symmetry. If you cut through the central axis, you will get two equal copies and a coelomate. Already we learned absence of coelom flatworm, tapeworm, or these are the examples for a coelomate. An important word in this here is flame cells. Flame cells are used for the excretion purposes, like a kidney, like we are having the kidney for the excretion, like that these animals have flame cells for the excretions. And these organisms are hermaphrodite. Note this point, hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodites are the organisms which contains both these sexes. So a single organism containing both the sex are called as hermaphrodites. Example, liver fluke. So look at the picture carefully. This is liver fluke, comes under flatworms, and this is the tapeworm, which also comes under flatworm. And coming to the roundworm, it belongs to the phylum Aschelminthes, and these are also bilateral and triploblastic in nature, that is consists of three germ layers. And this is pseudocoelomate, false coelom. Here absence of coelom, here false coelom. Little bit advanced from that flatworms. Example, Ascaris and Eucheria. Carefully note, look at the picture. This is Ascaris. So edges are rounded. These are Ascaris and this is a Eucheria. Eucheria causes a disease called elephantiasis. So here also some bending will be there. Look at the picture carefully. Sometimes they may ask by giving the picture, name the picture and which phylum it belongs to, like that they may ask, and what are the special characteristics they may ask. So here the special characteristic is pseudocoelomate and bilateral symmetry. Here the special characteristics of these animals is flame cells and hermaphrodite, students. And sometimes they may ask, platyhelminthes is otherwise called as flatworms, Aschelminthes is otherwise called as roundworm. In next session we will see the remaining phylums.